So now, let's analyze the effect of right heart catheterization with the weighted data set. So the important things for the outcome analysis with the weighted data set, and we need to use a regression with the weighting option. And also, because the weighted data set contains multiple data from a single patient, and we need to compute the robust variance covariance, of the model parameter. So these two things are different from the regular analysis.In an outcome variable, and we are going to analyze hospital length of stay and survival. And then there are three variables for the outcome. And the first outcome is a hospital length of stay. This is a continuous variable. And we use a linear regression in the usual case. And also, we need to have specify the weighting options. So, we are going to use generalized linear regression options in ECR for this. And the second variable is a death in 30 days from ICU admission. This is the binary variable. And usually we use a binary logistic regression options. And then we are going to use a generalized linear model to do the binary logistic regression, for the same reason. And then the number three is death in 30 days from ICU admission plus time of death. For this, we use a Cox proportional hazard regression. And a Cox pH proportional hazard regression in ECR, we can specify weighting options. So use the regular Cox regression for this. And then for the part, we compute a robust variance covariance estimator for model parameters. And we are going to use this function called the COEF test. So this will enable us to compute robust variance covariance for the model parameters. Okay. So for these two things are slightly different from the regular analysis using linear regression, binary logistic regression, and Cox proportional hazard regression. So to do generalized linear model, we go to original menu, statistics, fit models, and generalize the linear model. Okay, and then we put hospital days as an outcome variable. And although this variable is heavily skewed, and we are going to log transform this variable. Okay, and then we put swung.num. This is a right heart catheterization variable. Okay, and then make sure you put weight.ate.glm.1. This is a stabilized ATE weight, and in the weighting option. Right? And then generalize a linear model, we can do many regressions. If you want to do linear regression, you need to specify Gaussian for family options and identity for link function option. Okay. And then by click OK, and this will do linear regression with the weighting option. And then the second part, we need to re-estimate model parameter by using robust variance covariance estimators. And to do that, and we need to use a package called LMTest. So let's install those package, and then also another package called the Sandwich, right? And install this one, and then conduct COEF test for the result of generalized linear model we just did with the ECR. The result does not provide confidence interval and also exponential of the beta coefficient. So we are using ECR as a hand calculator to compute these results. Okay, so let's do this part in ECR. Okay, let's do the analysis with ECR. So go to original menu, statistics, fit models, and choose generalize the linear model. Okay, so first we will do linear regression. So you type here log hosp days, and then put the swung.num here, right? And then weight variable, we use stabilized weight for now, and then choose Gaussian here, and then identity as a link function. Sometimes you may find difficulty to pick identity here, but as long as you choose Gaussian for the family, that will automatically change link function to identity. So go ahead to click OK. And then after you run it, and make sure you have Gaussian parentheses identity appears on the screen. Okay. if you have logit or other link function, and then you can just hunt type your identity, and then highlight and then re-execute. So this p-value is still not correct because we are going to update this p-value by using a robust variance covariance estimator. Okay, and so I'll go back to slide and copy these five lines, and then back to the EZR, and then under here we paste these five lines. This gm.1, we actually need to match this with the previous run. So this is gln7, so we need to change this to 7 and then run the whole five line. So this is the final result. So p-value will be a little bit larger compared to the one without using robust variance covariance estimator. But this one is a correct one to use. We don't have 95% confidence interval, so we are going to compute that by hand. Okay, so lower 95% confidence interval is computed, can be computed as 0.1349 minus 1.96 times 0.0638, which is a standard error. Okay, and highlight this part and submit. So this is a lower confidence interval. Do the same thing for upper 95% confidence interval. So this part will be the plus. And then highlight and submit. So this is how you get the confidence interval. This is how you may interpret the result. There is 0.1349 log hospital days difference in average between the two groups with 95% confidence interval 0.009852 and 0.259948. Although understanding result with a log scale is difficult, so let's anti-log this to put it in the original scale. And to do that, and we need to compute mean ratio. Mean ratio, we can compute exponential of 0.1349. Okay. Exponentiate this, submit. This is 1.14. So mean ratio is 1.14. So this means the mean of hospitals in right heart catheterization group is actually 14.4% greater compared with non RHC group. This is actually the wrong number, so I will go to recompute this. And the 95% confidence interval, and then we actually in ratio, and we compute us. And in order to see the result, just highlight this one and submit. And so this is the lower confidence interval. So that means upper confidence interval, highlight this part and submit. This is a 29, so about 30%. So that's 30% here. Okay. So here's interpretation. The mean of hospitals in right heart catheterization group is 13.4% greater compared with the non-catheterization group with the 95% confidence interval is 1 to 30%. So the next, let's analyze the second outcome variable of 30-day hospital deaths, which is a binary outcome variable. So we are going to do logistic regression, but this time also use generalized linear model. Okay, so we go to original menu, statistics, fit models, generalized linear model. And outcome variable would be death 30, which is a binary variable, 1 for death and 0 for survived. And then we have swung.num as an independent variable. And then here we are going to use stabilized weight. And then since we are doing a logistic regression, binary logistic regression, make sure that under family option be binomial, right? And then we need to choose logit function. I can't actually select the logit, but let's go ahead to just run this model and see what happens. So the binomial, we need to change this to logit. Right? And then execute it again. So here, make sure this is binomial parenthesis logit. So this is a logistic regression. And again, this p-value is not the correct one yet. So to compute the correct one, what we have to do is do the same thing. It's here. Highlight these five lines all together and then place under here. And then this would be, this is glm.9. So I just want to make sure this is 9 so that it's consistent. And then submit, right? So this is the correct p-value. And again, this analysis does not give odds ratio nor the confidence interval. So if you want to compute odds ratio, this is how you do. And highlight OR, that is the odds ratio, and 95% lower 95% confidence interval. So this one, and then upper 95% confidence interval, and then this is the upper confidence interval. And finally, we will do the Cox proportional hazard regression for survival outcome. So we have death 30. So this is just a regular Cox proportional hazard regression. And then we have death days 30, and then event is the death 30. And then here, in the Cox proportional hazard regression, we need to hunt type weight options here because there's no box created to put the weight. Okay, so we have to hunt type here and then click OK. So let's do this part and go to survival analysis, Cox proportional hazard regression. So this is a regular way to do Cox proportional hazard regression. And then we put this day 30 and this 30 and small num here, and then here we need to type weight equal and then this variable. Okay, so that's weight dot ate dot glm dot one. All right, and then click OK. So this is the result of the analysis, but this p-value is not correct yet. We have to do the same thing. So here, and we'll do it again. So this say Cox model dot 10. So we just have to fix this to 10, right? And then submit. And this is the correct p-value. And then again, the same way, if you want to compute hazard ratio, and you compute exponential of sine, right? So this will give hazard ratio and confidence interval. That's hazard ratio. And this is a lower confidence interval and an upper confidence interval. This is a result of the analysis. So I did for each of outcome variable and applied three data sets, stabilized AT weights and ATT weights and a PS one-to-one matching. And surprisingly, the results are actually different by changing the method. And so, like for example, using a weights approach, these two are relatively similar. But the one we have matching, the hostile length of stay, the weight approach, both weights show statistically significant result, but matching, it does not show the statistical significance, although for the mortality, logistic regression, and Cox regression, the results are reversed. Weight approach provide non-significant result, but the matching approach find a significant result. So it is actually the result of the analysis is sensitive to the choice of the method. And we actually do have to be very careful to interpret the result. So this is the baseline comparisons. for each method. And again, even when I look at these, the differences in the baseline tables, I can't really find the reasonable explanation for the differential result. Well, therefore, identifying analytical method before looking at the data is very important. So, conducting several analyses as a sensitivity analysis to show robustness of the result is okay, but what method you would use as a main analysis you have to predetermine and before analyzing data set. Propensity score analysis seems complex, but I hope you enjoyed learning this method.